Hello, today we're looking at calculating the area of a shape that's not a proper shape. When we're looking at this shape here, we can see that it's two rectangles stuck together. And we've got one, two, three, four sides, but we don't have this side or this side calculated for us. So we know that the first thing that we need to do is to separate this into two different shapes. So we could separate our shape this way, or we could separate our shape this way. Either way, it doesn't matter which way we separate our shape, so long as we do cut it in half. So whichever way works best for you, go for it. For today's example, we're going to separate our shape this way. Now, we know that we have 1, 2, 3 lines going up and down, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3 lines going side to side. So first, we're going to write down the length of our lines, the numbers that match up to them, on these lines that I've drawn over here. So going up and down, we've got 10, we've got 4, and this side, we don't have the number for it yet. So now when we're going our horizontal or our side to side lines, we've got 12, we've got 2, and this line, we don't have the length yet. So when we're looking at these lines, we can see that in our side to side lines, our 10 over here is the distance from the top to the bottom of the shape. Over here, our 4 is part way, and this line is the rest of the way, filling up the full side of our 10. So we know that this side here, we're going to call it X, is 10 take away our 4 over here. So when we do 10 take away 4, if we count it on our fingers, we've got 10 minus 4 is 10. 9, 8, 7, 6. So we know that this side over here is 6. When we're calculating the area of a shape, we're working on all of the space inside of it. And when we're doing that, our formula is area equals length times width, or side times side. So for our blue shape, we have our length, or our longer side, is 6 times our smaller side, which is 2. If we're going to make this a bit easier for ourselves, I know a lot of our courses let us use a calculator, so if we bring it up, we need to make sure that we're using all of the right functions. So we have 6 times 2 equals 12. So on this shape, we're going to write inside, I was going to go to the back, 12, and if we're going to pretend that all of these are meters, which I probably should have written in sooner, there's going to be 12 meters squared. Now for our green shape over here. What two numbers come together? What two numbers do we times to get this? So what is our length and what is our width? Our length, or the longer side, is 12 times our width, which is our smaller side, 4. So if we come back and we do 12 times 4 equals 48. So we know that this side is 48 meters squared. So we've got side 1, and we have side 2. We know that we're going to have to add these two sides together. So we have 48 plus 12 gives us 8, 9, 10. Put down our 0, carry our 1. 4 5, 6. So we know that our answer is 60 meters squared. Now we're going to have a look at this shape over here. So I'm going to try and draw that just a little bit better. There we go. So this shape over here, I want you guys to pause the video. I've drawn up our three lines going top to bottom, our vertical lines, vertical, and our three lines going side to side, or our horizontal lines. So I want you to write down the values of those lines, and I want you to see if we can work out what the blank sides are. So pause the video, write it down in your books, try it out. Okay, now to check our answers. So our vertical going up and down lines, we have 8 and we have 3. And our last one, we don't know. And our vertical lines going side to side, we have 10 and we have 2. And our last one, we don't know. So if we separate our shape this way, we need to work out what this length is here. And we know that this side is 8 and this side is 8 take away 3. So 8 take away 3 is 8, 7, 6, 5. So we can write 5 over here, and we're going to give meters to all of our lengths again. So if we make this our blue shape, so blue shape area equals length times width. So what is our length here? What is our long side? Our long side is 5 times our width, which is our smaller side, which is 2. 5 times 2 gives us 10 meters squared. Next we have, Okay, so my whiteboard here is frozen, it's likely to shut down. Yeah, there we go. But if I double click it to open it up again, no, there we go. Bear with me, I'm really sorry. So we're back here. We're working out the value of our green side. So the area of our green shape is length times width, and our length, or our long number, is 10 times our width, or our short number, which is 3. 10 times 3 gives us 30 meters squared. Now we know that these are the two shapes separated, but we have this area that's joining them together. So we need to do 30 plus 10, which will give us 0 plus 0, 0, 3 plus 1, 44, which gives us 40 meters squared. And 40 meters squared is the area of both of these sides together. I'm going to track down some extra questions, and I want you to follow every step, writing down the values of our sides, looking at if we need to plus or minus the sides, and then finding the area of the shapes inside. If you need any help, ask me in class.